Cam Ward, Cam Coley, and Brandon Sutter back out to center. Oh, is he hit? Oh, my goodness, a high hit from Doug Wade, and they're going after 93. Nicky Vallee wants a piece of Wade. Oh, boy. Price to be paid here. Brandon Sutter had his head down in neutral ice, and he was lined up by Doug Wade.
Well, Vallee is really going after Campoli. And right now, just shift your eyes to Brandon Sutter, not what's going on here after. And just about to make another sparkling play. And everybody knows the history that we've seen of these head injuries in Carolina. We'll have to go back and look at this one again. Let's take a look here, John.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, boy.
Now, you know, we get into this blow to the head stuff, Trip. You know, when you look at a hit like this, Sutter has the puck, turns away a bit, and there it is. And it's a clean hit with intention, but it is high over the shoulder, right on the head. There it is. And they're supposed to crack down on this stuff.
Well, I'm going to tell you, that arm is right into the body. And you know, I know there's no intent whatsoever on the part of Doug Wade. And I can tell you, nobody feels worse right now than Doug Wade. Now, that doesn't take away from the fact that this shining, promising rookie right now is down and not moving very much. But to me, when you just break it down objectively from the looks that I've seen, the puck is there, that arm is in, the puck has not departed from, you know, to the point where you say that you need to peel off. At least the couple of looks that I saw, that's what I would conclude.
No, it's not a late hit. There's no question about that. Sutter remains on the ice, and you see the medical personnel on the ice again. Here it is, the puck in the vicinity, so it's not one of those situations where it's long gone, and then the hit by Doug Wade.
It's not a rising hit either that would make me upset that it's a blow to the head. When he's moving in, and I don't know, it almost looked like as Brandon was leaning in to try to chip that puck forward, his head actually came down. And so it would have been a shoulder to shoulder. Now it's a shoulder to head. And how's Doug Wade supposed to know that? I don't know. That's a tough one to call every which way. And most importantly, with what's going on here in the third period and things that Brandon Sutter's doing, I mean, things have stopped.
It's a tough call because, you know, unless they go black and white on this, where any hit to that area of the body is illegal. And what they say is that they're trying to crack down on this, and they have supplemental discipline certain hits like this. But unless they put it in stone that any hit to that area of the body is illegal, then a player would know that and not do that. Yeah. Now, I think you're right in the way he hit him with his shoulder and then did come up in that area. But, you know, again, he sees where he's at and he knows the fact that he's going to hit him high, and he does make contact. And you can see the concern on Doug Wade, because there aren't too many more classy players in the National Hockey League than a guy like this. Sutter is up now, seems to be able to communicate with Jason Bailey and the medical staff here at Nassau Coliseum.
And anybody that watched the intermission interview with Doug, and of course all Canes fans are well aware of what he stands for. You know, but this is like the perfect storm right now. And Sutter comes out after scoring his first goal, just an absolute terrific play earlier in the period to set up Chad LaRose for just a beautiful goal. Again, shorthanded, it looked like he could have another breakaway. And then to me is a clean hit from, you know, for Doug Wade to deliver it. I think it's a clean hit. It's just a very, very unfortunate situation.